following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
Listen, we've got everybody you like on Sesame Street today. Buddy and Jim, Ernie and Bert, a lot of your favorites are gonna be here. And as soon as we get a chance, we're gonna see everybody. And I've got, do you know what I just did? Do you know what I just did? I just put that trash in the Oscar's trash can. Oscar is gonna be warm. Hi, Oscar.
Did you do this?
Yeah, I did, but see, it was an accident. It wasn't something I wanted to do. It was an accident, I, you know.
I'm sure it was, Gordon. You know, mistakes will happen. When you live in a trash can, you have to expect this sort of thing, you know? Say, you're looking very well today, Gordon.
Thank you.
Great. It's really a beautiful day, isn't it? Oh, what a beautiful morning.
Yeah, it is a... Hey, Oscar. Is something wrong with you?
Oh, yeah, there certainly is.
Well, what is it? Tell me, you're not right.
I don't know. I feel happy today. Isn't that awful? You know, usually I'm grumpy and grouchy, and I really feel good and rotten. But today, I feel all warm and pleasant. It's terrible.
Well, listen, little O. I mean, how did this happen?
Well, I don't really know. I guess maybe I got up on the right side of the bed.
Well, I've seen some weird things before, but I don't know about this.
Hey, you wouldn't like to come to the park with me and smell the flowers and listen to the little birdies in the trees, Would you?
No.
Or maybe we could play with some toys. Hey, look. I borrowed Ernie's rubber ducky. Hi, little fella.
You all right? I can't believe it. Oscar's in a good mood.
Yeah.
You're kidding, aren't you?
No. I mean this. No, you have to see for yourself.
Yes, I have.
Now, look at this. He's in there. He's in a good mood.
Oscar? Impossible.
No, look at Oscar. Come on.
Well, hi there, Gordon. And hello, Susan. I'm glad you came by to see me. It's always pleasant to have good friends visit.
I don't believe it.
Don't believe what?
You're in a good mood. I mean, you're happy. You're not grouchy.
Well, I don't understand it either. I woke up feeling wonderful. It's disgusting. I feel terrible.
Huh. Well, it certainly is different, I can say that.
By the way, can I offer you some milk and cookies?
That would be nice.
Yeah, it would be pleasant. I think it would. I'll go get them. I can't really stand myself like this. But I'll go get the cookies.
Okay, now what do you think?
He is really strange.
Yeah, Oscar. It's really weird thinking of Oscar as a nice guy, you know?
You know, and he said he doesn't really feel so good this way. Do you think that maybe we should help him get back to his old self?
Yeah, let's get him back to his old grouchy self. You know how to do it. Come on, we can do this.
Okay.
Wait till he gets back up here.
There we go. Here are the very nice little cookies I promised. And after this, I'm going to read some poetry and nice things like that.
Oscar, we don't want these old cookies. They're stale.
No, get back down the trash can, Oscar. We don't need you right now.
I just thought because it was a
Yeah, I know. You thought it was a lovely day. It's not a lovely day. Look, it's a rotten day. Worst day I ever saw in my life.
And who needs all this old sunlight? Ugh!
But I was just saying
Yeah, you're always trying to say, talk out your mouth. You can't do that. We don't want to hear it.
And you know what? You drive me crazy with all that talk.
Listen! If you don't want my crummy cookies, then forget it. You won't get them. See if I care. I didn't ask you to come here, you know.
We did it.
Did what?
We did. We made you a grouch again.
You back to your old grouchy self?
Hey, you did it. I am a grouch again. Hey, that does feel better. Thanks.
Yeah, you know, we like you being a grouch.
You do like me this way?
Sure. You know, we've gotten so used to you, and we just kind of like you the way you are.
Hey, watch that. None of that gooey, lovey-dovey stuff with me. Blech, it's terrible. Now, why don't you go away and leave me alone? Boy, the people that come around here are just ridiculous. I don't have no...
Good old Oscar, my man.
I hope he never changes.
Yes. Snake. Yeah.
Well, I think S is the best letter. You know why? Because it's the first letter in the name Susan.
It's time to play. One of these things is not like the others. Are you ready? Okay. One of these things is not like the others. One of these things doesn't belong. Can you tell which thing is not like the others by the time I finish my song? All right, let's look at each one. Now, this is the letter S. This is the letter S. This is the letter S. And this is the letter S. Now, be careful. You have to figure out which one is different. Did you guess which thing is not like the others? Did you guess which thing doesn't belong? If you guess this thing is not like the others, then you're right. But let's see if you know why you're right. Now, let's look. See, I have this nifty S right here, and it's the same size as this S, and that's a big S. This is a big S, and this is a big S. But look over here. You see, that's a small S. That's why it doesn't belong, and it's smaller than the other three. Did you get that? So it's a matter of size. These are big, and this one is small. Good. I'm glad. All right. You know something else? Another word that starts with S is sleep.
Yeah, you can feed him.
Hey, Bambi.
Bambi? Uh-huh. Don't give Bambi too much. Okay. Grab a seat, Steve. Bambi is a fallow deer, an English fallow deer. Did you know that?
No.
But you do now, right?
Yeah, uh-huh. Hey, Bambi.
Take a guess at how old Bambi is.
9 months.
That's not a bad guess. You can make a guess, Vanessa. Oops.
7 months.
Hey, 7 months, you're right. 7 months old.
Hey, Bambi.
This deer comes from the Mediterranean countries. Those are countries around the Mediterranean Ocean. Oops. Was it sea? What is it? Who knows? Mediterranean Sea. Ocean. Anyway, it's a deer. We know that.
Hey, Bambi.
Oh, Bambi. Bambi. Steve? Where are you going, Bambi? Let's take a walk.
Hey, Bambi.
Bambi is all of 7 months old. He eats vegetation, or she eats vegetation.
I think it's a she.
She! Bambi is a she. You know how I knew that? Huh? You do?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, how did I know that? The great English fallow deer lady came down, flying down Sesame Street and told me, come back, Bambi. Bambi, not too far. You got enough, Vanessa? Want some more?
Bambi. She ate a little more.
Come here. Let's get this out from under. Oops. Whoop. That's a very tiny, delicate little leg. Let's not get it all tied up. Where you going, Bambi? Bring it out here, Steve.
Bambi.
Bambi? I don't care what happens if they lay an egg. Egg is an E word, and this is a big E, right?
Yes.
The big letter E, or what they call the capital letter E. That's the big one. Know why it's a big one? Because there's also a small one. It goes like that. Small letter E, you see? Big E, small E. They sound exactly alike, no matter what you do. One sounds like E, the other sounds like E, or sometimes one sounds like eh, the other sounds like eh. Doesn't matter. Big one, small one, they're just written differently, but they sound the same. Josh, what would you like to know about pheasants? I'm an old pheasant man from way back. What do you know? What do you want to know about them? Hmm? You don't know what you want to know, huh? Well, I'll tell you, those are pheasants. Those are two pheasants. And the one in the back, the sort of drab-looking pheasant, that's the female pheasant, the lady pheasant. And the one in the front with the colors, with the red around his face and the blue plume and the dark blue or black, and that's the male. You know why the male's got all those pretty colors? You don't? Take a guess. Go on. What do you think?
I don't know.
Okay. It's because he has those pretty colors so that he can attract the female. Female pheasant comes up to the male pheasant and says, my, look at all those swinging pretty colors you have. They come from Asia. Do you know where Asia is? Well, I'll tell you, it's a very, very, very big place. And pheasants were born, were originated, started in Asia, around China. And nowadays, they're almost anywhere. Lots and lots of pheasants around. You like the red feet, huh?
I don't know why it has red feet.
Because that's a red foot pheasant. Did you ever think of that? That's why it has red feet. Why did you think it had red feet?
I don't
Didn't know, huh? Well, one thing you can be sure of is that you have two pheasants there, right? And lots of animals come in twos. Just watch. Two parrots, Josh. And two monkeys. Two tigers. Two geese, right? Two baby hyraxes, imagine that. And two penguins. Two rhinos. And two baby gazelles. There you have two giraffes. And two bears waving bye-bye, huh? Okay, this is what you've been waiting all day for. This is the sounds game. And you say, Gordon, how do you play the sounds game? Well, show you. What is that? That's Ernie's rubber ducky, right? But it should make a sound like a duck. Now you listen to this sound and see whether this sound is the sound that a duck makes. Listen. Is that it? Is that a duck sound? Huh? No, that's not the sound a duck makes. Well, what about this? Huh? Was that what was making the sound? Fire engine? Oh, I think you're right. Let's listen to it again. That was it. That was a fire engine sound. Okay. Try another one. I happen to have a cow here. Nice cow. Now, let's listen to the cow. See if this is a cow sound. No? No? You sure? That is not a cow sound. All right. Get it down here. What do you think that was? You think maybe it was being made by this typewriter? Huh? Well, let's listen. Try it again. You're absolutely right. How can you be wrong? Typewriter sound. Right. Pretty good. All right. Now, would you like to try another one? You would? Okay. Happen to have a doll here. It's Holly's doll. Now, let's listen to the doll and see if this is a doll sound, okay? Now, was that a doll sound? Was it? No. You say no, and you mean it. That's not a doll sound. Now, what could have been making that sound? Car? Well, let's listen again. You're absolutely right. That was a car sound. I'll show you something. Remember the doll? It makes a sound like meh. Sometimes it cries, you know. Mommy, some of them say mommy, some of them say I want to go to the store, some of them say all kinds of things, but they don't make car sounds. And your cow, remember the cow goes meh. Or makes a kind of moo sound out in the pasture, right? That's how the cow works. And duck, you know, a duck goes quack, 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 right? Doesn't sound like a fire engine. You know, you can find out a lot from sounds if you listen to them carefully. Sounds, you see, those are all things to groove on with your ears, and that's called listening. And there are things to groove on with your eyes, and that's called seeing. There are lots of things I could sit and look at all day, like, well, this is one. You know what these are? These are pictures. And this is a young guy who is going fishing. And here's another picture of him fishing. And your job is to tell which one of these pictures came first. Follow me?
Hey.
Oh, hi, Oscar.
Don't sweet talk me. Just tell me what's that stuff in your hand there.
Well, these are pictures, Oscar. You know, we're trying to figure out which one came first. Well, this picture came first, Or that picture came first, or the boy fishing?
Never mind those crummy pictures. Just come over here and I'll show you some of the real stuff and see if you can figure it out.
All right.
Go ahead.
What do you have over here, Oscar?
Well, I have some real items, and see if you can figure out which came first, okay?
All right. Let's...
Don't go away.
I won't. Come on.
Now, look at this stuff.
Silverware. Yeah, but this is old, dirty, beat-up silverware.
Oh. Now, look at this.
New silverware, huh?
That's the new stuff.
New shiny silverware.
Now, the problem is, see if you can figure out which came first.
Oh, this is very easy, Oscar. You see, this old silverware, this old beat-up silverware, that was stuff that you had a long time ago. You used it and used it and used it until you got tired of it because it was old, beat-up, and dirty-looking silverware, and you went out and got some new ones. So the old silverware came first, and the new silverware came after that.
Look, see if you can do, how you can do on this next item.
Well, it made sense to me.
There, try this one.
Oh, yeah. Well, it was a vase, right? Flower vase, and it's a broken one.
Yeah, now look at this.
I know what happened here. Oh, yeah, that's a new one. It's a new flower vase that's not broken. Oscar, the answer is very simple. I'll tell you what's happening. This one, you broke. You had an accident. Broke the flower vase, right? And since you broke it, you didn't want a broken flower vase around your house, so you got rid of that, got a brand new one. Therefore, now listen carefully, the broken one came first, and the new one came after you broke the old one.
See if you can do all right on this next one.
Well, man, doesn't that make sense to you? Broken one, new one.
Now look at that.
A rotten, rancid rug. Oscar, this is an old... A nice new nappy rug. Look at that. Now, I'll tell you what happened. Very simple, Oscar. I understand. This old, beat-up, rotten, rancid rug was the one that you had for a long time down there in your trash can. You walked and stomped all over it. The monster tripped over it and everything. And you got tired of it because you didn't want an old, dirty rug.
No.
And you got a brand new one. So this one came first,
and
that one came afterward. No.
No. That just goes to show you what you know about grouches. Boy, I had all that new shiny stuff around, and it was really depressing me. The new stuff I had first, so I went out, and I got a lot of dirty, busted, rusty, gucked up, icky, lungy junk to make me feel better. You never will understand us grouches.
You know, he's right. I never will.
Let's see here. Wanted. Clerk, typist.
Hello, Big Bird.
Hello, Gordon.
What are you up to?
Well, I'm just looking through the want ads here in the paper.
Oh, yeah?
Let's see. Machinist helper.
You looking for a job?
Yes, I'm looking for a job, so I'm looking at the want ads in the classified section.
Oh, yeah?
To see if I can find a job. Somebody might need a Big Bird.
Well, what kind of job are you looking for, Big Bird?
Well, I don't know. What do you do, Gordon?
Me? Well, yeah, I teach at the high school.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Hey, that's an idea. I'll be a teacher. I'll teach at the high school.
Well, that's not a bad idea, Big Bird, but what are you going to teach?
I could teach flying.
No, I don't think it's too safe.
I could teach him how to grow feathers. I've got lots of them. I could show him.
Well, no, I don't think so.
How to be clumsy. I'm clumsy.
No.
Well, then I won't be a teacher. I'll be a policeman.
Well, you're a little tall for that, and you might not be able to fit in the police car, you know?
That's true.
Yeah.
Wait, I could be a fireman. I'll run that hook and ladder. Put out the fires.
Fireman. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, but you know what? Firemen have big boots, but I don't know if they have... boots big enough for your feet with your three toes, you know. Listen, Big Bird, why do you want a job anyway in the first place? I mean, you know.
Well, I want to make myself useful. be helpful around here.
But birds, you're useful.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, sure. I mean, look at the things you do. You reach up in high places for us when we can't get there, right?
Yeah.
You play with the children. You keep them happy, and you don't let them run out in the street.
Well,
you run errands for Mr. Hooper. You run errands for Susan and things for Bob. You know, you're one of the most useful people here on Sesame Street.
I am?
Sure.
Then I won't get a job. I'll stay right here and be useful.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, he can't go away and get a job. And if he did, who'd run into things? Boy, when a baby chick says moo, it's time to go. And it's that time. But we'll come back and join you on Sesame Street. You come back and join us, okay? All right, see you later.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters E, S, and W, and by the numbers 2 and 3. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.